Namaskar, I am Subhajit Mukherjee, founder of Mission Green Mumbai. I have been dedicatedly working in mitigating the effects of climate change by creating a citizens' movement for climate action with 2,000 plus volunteers focused in three major areas. First, protection and nurturing of existing trees. Second, plantation of new native trees in scientific manner. And third, awareness initiatives on innovations for nature conservation. Today, I want to highlight how human activities have disrupted our ecosystem and what we can do to save the planet. Concretization of urban landscape due to paver blocks, cemented roads, tiles, and synthetic playground is not allowing the rainwater to percolate into the ground during monsoon, thereby leading to heat island effect. The heat island, the heat trapped in the concrete for a long time, leads to an increase in the surface temperature. Infrastructure development activities have led to the loss of green cover around us, leading to a heating of air we breathe. Heated air holds less oxygen, which leads to medically proven health concerns like shortening of breath, loss of stamina and mental fatigue, leading to reduction in our life expectancy, which is a major concern. Growth and survival of trees are affected due to fresh water shortage and groundwater decline. Deep-rooted trees are water-starved, leading to slow and smaller growth of trees around us. Young trees do not survive post-monsoon as they fail to reach the groundwater level. Saline water, which is the seawater at the coastal regions, have entered the fresh groundwater areas, leading to decline in tree roots. The roots are getting decayed and therefore falling of the trees are happening during storms. We are concerned about the Earth's global average temperature rise, and we are here with simple solutions that can be implemented by all individuals present here. My climate action plan is economical, quick to learn, and easy to implement. It has resulted in plantation of thousands of trees under mini urban forest and installed another thousands of rainwater harvesting percolation barrels. I have brought individuals, NGOs, government bodies, social groups, and people around us together to mitigate the effects of climate change. WHO, the World Health Organization, has estimated that 7 million people died due to the diseases caused by air pollution in the year 2021. Urban mini forests are looked at as a solution to the pollution problem. It is scientifically proven climate action plantation technique in land-starved mega cities to create a carbon sink and help biodiversity to survive. It's an exclusive protected green zone in to balance the ecosystem around us. It provides a forest experience for the individuals to connect with nature. And definitely the health benefits, how can we forget? Let us understand what a mini forest is. It is a minimum space of 1,000 square feet area that holds a promising change to protect our health from suspended particulate matters. It is like a very small, smallest form of pollution flying around in the air, which we call SPM 2.5 and 10, that gets into our lungs as air pollution. It has been inspired by new research, native trees are identified and planted with the help of botanists. Water and sunlight availability is checked. Soil is tested and necessary nutrients and fertilizers are added to improve the soil quality. After meeting all the requirements and conditions, 3 to 4 trees are planted in a box or a pyramid formation so that the trees have to compete for the sunlight. This triggers 4 times faster growth and multiplied growth compared to the traditional plantation method. Also, It creates a safe haven for birds, butterflies to multiply. Grey water can be utilized after basic filtration from nearby societies or wherever the water source is available and reduce the pressure on fresh water. In the last 3 years, 5 lakh plus trees are planted in this method in Mumbai. The government and corporates are sponsoring such plantation drives through experts. If you can dedicate 1,000 square feet only of protected land around you from the human interventions with the willingness to nurture, then a lot of NGOs will be happy to come forward and gift you a mini forest. In 2010, I started the initiative because of my passion of planting trees. However, I realized the importance of our vision when many citizens came forward to adopt uprooted trees due to construction of metro rail. On a Sunday, I experienced the strength of citizens' action that made impossible projects possible in last so many years. One such initiative was Each One Plant One project that went on for 5 years, and it was a huge success as it resulted in massive tree plantation and adoption by citizens across MMR region. I was truly heartwarmed to experience families and friends coming together to celebrate their happiness by planting trees despite of their busy schedule. I remember a couple planting an urban forest as a part of their wedding ceremony. A 10-year-old made his grandmother's 80th birthday memorable by planting 80 trees. It was really an emotional moment for me. I have realized that I might have failed individually, but yes, as a team, I always win. In all these years, this is my real learning. As a founder of Mission Green India, I urge citizens to come forward and plant such zen space for their own health and well-being. However, for planting more trees, you will need more water. And where from this water come from? That's the topic. Well, necessity is the mother of all inventions. Inspired by Jal Shakti Abhiyan, we came up with the most economical rainwater harvesting percolation barrel with filters and storage, and can be made with things available around us almost for free. We have installed 5,000 of these barrels across India and trained 43,000 plus college students on this technique of 2-in-1 RWH percolation barrel to catch the rain, thereby supporting groundwater recharge during monsoon and reuse of grey water for plantation and many other purposes post monsoon. I will explain the installation process with the help of pictures for better understanding. Step 1. Identify a land to dig a pit of 5 feet by 5 feet and 5 feet deep, which should be 10 feet away from the main building wall, and place a blue rain barrel at the center. Fill the space with lots of stones around it so for the water to percolate, and you can simply divert the terrace water into this particular barrel so that the monsoon water from the terrace gets into this barrel and percolates into the ground. As and when it overflows, it'll escape into the ground from the stones nearby. It's very simple as you look at the diagram. The extra water, as I said, will be either in the barrel, or the overflow water will go into the ground for giving additional health and environment benefits. My aim is to install this system in each and every premises that is connected and has the access to terrace water. Terrace water must be saved. We have to catch the rain where it falls and when it falls. Remember, the time has come for us to grow our own oxygen by planting our own tree, else we do not have the rights to breathe. Similarly, we have to first conserve water and then consume water. Remember that. It's a request. It is now or never. Thank you.